With 2012 fast approaching, the veil has been lifted on what we can expect this New Year's Eve on Sydney Harbour.
And 10's Lachlan Kennedy joins us now from Dawes Point. Lachlan, they always manage to outdo themselves. How are organisers planning to top last year?
Well, Bill, early this morning I didn't think they could top last year, but now I'm so convinced. I've gone out and downloaded the official Sydney New Year's app, and I can tell you there's 30 days, 6 hours, 49 minutes and 15 seconds to midnight. But who really is counting? What can we expect when the clock strikes 12? Well, lots of different types and new types of fireworks this year. They are promising a lot more to do with the bridge in terms of waterfalls, different colours cascading down this year. And of course, there is a new theme. This year it's called Time to Dream. So get your thinking caps on what that could mean to you. The other big changes are to do with music. For the first time, the event has its own official anthem. It's called We Are the Light, and I warn you, it is very catchy. You can download it from iTunes, with all proceeds going to charity. As well, there is, for the first time, when the clock strikes midnight, all the fireworks will be synchronised to a soundtrack made entirely of Australian music. We know some big bands like AC/DC and In Excess will be played, but also there'll be heaps of indie artists who don't know their music is going to be played on the world stage. So it will be a very big surprise for them, a great night for us all, and Council is promising it will be an environmentally sustainable event as well.
On top of Sydney's greenest building, the Lord Mayor had a choir to help sing the praises of a green New Year's.
We try to ensure that everything we do is sustainable.
That includes hosting Australia's premier party. Even the crackers this year will be biodegradable.
Probably one of the biggest fireworks displays around the world.
Going green will cost more. The event's price tag is up to $6.3 million.
It's 8 hours entertainment. So it's approximately $4 per person.
That entertainment will have a distinct Aussie feel. For the first time, the midnight soundtrack will feature only local artists. But the playlist is so secret, most bands haven't been told.
Trying to make people cry, trying to make people jump, trying to make people get excited and have a party.
There's one other big surprise.
What will be front and centre on the bridge is still a big secret, but this logo did appear everywhere at today's theme launch. They call it the never-ending rainbow, but to many people it may just look like a circle.
It represents the different layers of our culture coming together for one night. There's even an uplifting theme song to go with it. It's already very catchy, and there are 30 days to go. Lachlan Kennedy, 10 News.